What's up, everybody? James Martin, Terribly Tough. This interview, what we're doing is talking about working out and what is the best diet, the best workout for your fitness level. Talk about what is the workout plan when your life is busy, different lifestyles, different responsibilities and priorities. So we're gonna start with Alex and then we're gonna go to me when it comes to working out, best diet. How would you work it throughout your lifestyle? How's your lifestyle right now? How busy are you? And how does working out come into your life?
I'm busy as hell, but that's really because it's a good busy, because I'm busy as hell working, driving Uber, Lyft, and at the same time making videos for my YouTube channel and Instagram, because you know that's my passion, that's what I like to do. And that energizes me. It doesn't matter how busy I am.
And that's the thing with me too. I work 9 hours. When I come home, I'm tired and I gotta show attention to the wife. But then on top of that, I gotta find time to work out. I gotta find time to edit a video and think of interesting topics. So how do I do that? How do I work it around my schedule? So my schedule is probably like 12 p.m. to about 8:30 at night. After that, what I do is I come home, I eat, I spend an hour with the wife, and I try to go to sleep early, because what I wanna do is I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning, so I have 3 hours of silence. The wife is still sleeping. I'm not working until 12 o'clock, so I have 4 to 5 hours to myself to actually pop out a few videos, edit, work out, and I can actually go running for about a mile or 2 miles just to get it in. It's uncomfortable in the beginning, but you have to do it. If you want to get to and accomplish a lot of goals, you have to get up early. You have to force yourself when you're tired and you don't feel like it. When you work a crazy, hectic job like we both do, you cannot always eat perfectly. You can't always have organic, vegan stuff. You basically are eating whatever is on the go because of your surroundings, because you're constantly moving. So with me, I'm constantly moving at work. I'm always standing, so I can't go get a salad. I gotta have McDonald's sometimes. So what do? You make it work. You make it work for you. You take the bun off and you just have the chicken sandwich. You just have the burger. You gotta eat whatever is around you. Just try to eat half of what you usually eat if it's something unhealthy. Okay, so what is your diet like?
All right, so what's been working for me lately is one meal a day.
Okay.
And the reason why that works is because you eat heavy, a big meal, right? As big as you can. And then the rest of the day, as you get hungry throughout the day, now you're not spending time and energy and money on looking for your next meal. Instead, you're using that hunger, that energy of hunger, to keep on working. And the second thing with that is, if you eat, you're using up energy to digest, and that lowers your energy up to create and to do other things like work or make videos or whatnot.
Okay, so you only eat one meal a day, right? So that one meal a day, what does it consist of?
Since it's one meal a day, I make it special. So okay. Like, I'll think the day before. So like, sometimes I'll go to my favorite place called My Salad, and I'll have like this giant grilled salmon salad with some avocado toast. So I'll have like two meals as one meal, mm-hmm. Right? Two meals as one meal. But then that's it. I eat that and then I don't have to worry about or think about eating again for the rest of the day. And the beautiful part is, 8 hours later, after all this food is digested, I have nothing but pure energy to keep on going and working. Yeah, sometimes I do get hungry and it sucks, but that's more of an addiction that I have to eating food. But when I overcome it by not eating and working and having all this extra energy to be productive, it feels even better the next day. And then that next meal the next day is like, it's just rewarding.
See, that's the good thing with intermittent fasting, because what happens is that you eat one big meal every like 18 hours or once a day. So what happens is that all that food that's stored in your stomach and holding onto it and goes into survival mode, because it has nothing fueling it throughout the day and giving you energy. So it takes that extra food that's inside your stomach and basically washes everything out, so it doesn't give you that bulge and you don't have the extra tummy fat. But what I do is I do keto diet. Keto diet consists of mostly protein instead of carbs, because I don't want to have that bulging belly. So I'll have like 4 to 5 meals a day every 3 hours, so that I have a constant flow of energy throughout the day, because food is energy. It depends on the person, because to me, I can't do intermittent fasting because I get a headache. If I don't eat every 3 to 4 hours, it's based on your lifestyle, how busy you are. If you're not such a busy person, maybe it works for you, maybe it doesn't. You got to play around and see what works for you. For me, keto diet works because I like that constant flow of protein throughout the day. I like to have variety, and with protein, you have fish, you have meat, you have peanuts, any types of protein. Okay, so basically we have two different styles of working out because there's not one style that you have to stick to when it comes to building muscle and having gains. Tell me, Alex, what is your workout regimen? How many times do you work out a week and how long?
I probably work out about 4 times a week. And I work out anywhere between 30 minutes to an hour.
Is that every body part?
I think I almost hit every body part. I do the basics. I do pull-ups, push-ups, I do back, I do the front part of the legs, I do legs, hamstrings, and then I do some running. And then I do arms. I pick a day for arms. So I do a little bit of everything. I don't really have a schedule. Mm-hmm. I think I should be on a schedule, but for the most part, I do 4 times a week, yes. 4 times a week ever since the pandemic. So I just do purely calisthenics for the most part and light weights.
Okay. I try to hit every body part every other day so I give myself a 1 day rest.
Really?
Because we don't have a gym, so there's not a lot of variety, a lot of machines that I can work on. So I might as well work every body part because it's going to take less time since I'm only working with dumbbells.
So let me hop on your workout schedule mm-hmm. since I need a change. What are you doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a variety of push-ups, but weighted push-ups, so that I'm basically working out the shoulders, triceps, and chest.
How do you do a weighted push-up?
So if you don't have weights at home because of pandemic,
you throw a weight on your back or something?
What you're going to do is get a book bag and fill it up with any other stuff you have, canned foods, any types of weight that you can add to your back to basically give yourself more of a resistance so you get better gains. Okay, so you're doing the entire upper body. So what I would do is get dumbbells. If not, what you're going to do is get the weighted book bag so that you can do the push-ups. You're also going to do arm curls. You're going to do preacher curls with the book bag full of weights. You're going to go upwards and do a shoulder press.
All right, so I'm doing a preacher curl. Boom, mm-hmm. boom.
Stop in the shoulder press position, and you're going to go back, and you're working triceps now with the weight. From there, you're going to go back up to original position, shoulder press, come down, and finish with the slow preacher curl.
And that's one.
That's one.
All right, cool.
Right there, you just work triceps.
Do I do? That's dope, dude.
You work triceps, shoulders, back.
And the exercise you do?
From there, you're gonna switch the backpack to your back and you're gonna start doing weighted push-ups. Just do a lot of push-ups and make it work for you.
Nice. All right, so, cool.
All right,
how
guys.
How do you do the weighted curls again?
Okay. From the weighted push-up position, what you're gonna do is now put the backpack on your knees. You're going to basically put it 6 inches off the ground, do weighted leg raises, leg crunches, and that's how you're gonna work. The abs, weighted abs, because a lot of us don't have gyms at home. So we have to compensate. We gotta basically work with what we have.
The curls with the shoulders, triceps.
So what I like about this exercise is hitting the triceps, biceps, shoulders, and back, all in one exercise. And it's fast, it's efficient, it's effective. So basically this is one exercise that you could do since you don't have a gym without anything other than just putting canned foods in your book bag to get a full result in regards to building the tricep, bicep, shoulder, and back. You're gonna do the average preacher curl. You're going to basically do the preacher curl with 20 pounds inside the book bag. From this position, you're going to go up to do the shoulder press. From the shoulder press, you're going to swing the book bag around and bring it down and do the tricep extension. Tricep extension comes back up. We put the book bag in front of you, bring it down, preacher curl position, and go slowly because you're now working the forearms. All right, guys, that's just a technique that I've been using during the pandemic that helped me to get my gains in order to help me get in better shape. All right, guys, if you have any questions, comment down below. Let me know. Subscribe down below. And we're all in this together. You need to basically work on yourself and get into better workout routines, think smarter, and actually get to the fitness. Stop wasting time and let's get into it. Subscribe down below. Terribly tough. Let me know. Comment.